From this video series, we are planning to give a basic introduction about test instruments which are available at an electrical or an electronic laboratory. As the first video, we are going to describe you about how to get familiarized with an oscilloscope and how to calibrate an oscilloscope. So, first I will introduce what is an oscilloscope. An oscilloscope, which was previously called as an oscillograph and informally known as a CRO or a DSO, is a type of electronic test instrument that allows observation of varying signal voltages. I highly underline that point, varying signal voltages, usually as a two-dimensional plot of one or more signals as a function of time. So, as you can see on this flat screen, it is showing your signal as a two-dimensional plot. Y-axis represents for the voltage and the x-axis represents for the time. So, today I'm basically going to introduce what can we do with the oscilloscope and how to calibrate an oscilloscope before you are going to test a circuit or any instrument with use of your oscilloscope. So, first we will begin with the basic equipment, the oscilloscope probe. As you can see, this oscilloscope probe has this clip to hook on with any circuitry part. Normally we consider this hook as positive part, and this obviously we need a ground or a negative portal to isolate your circuit. So before connecting your oscilloscope probe to any circuitry that you are going to test, first of all we have to calibrate your oscilloscope. Normally, oscilloscope calibrations are done manually with use of analog oscilloscope. But if you use a digital oscilloscope, you can do it by just clicking a one button, auto calibration, and the machine itself calibrate the oscilloscope. But today we are going to explain an analog oscilloscope where we have to calibrate it by manually. So this is a dual beam cathode ray oscilloscope. With the word dual beam means at once it can project two channels, two voltage signals can be analyzed and two circuitries can be analyzed, or you can see the product of two voltage signals, how it varies. So from a, basically from a voltage from an oscilloscope, what you can measure is, you can see your voltage signal's amplitude, the peak value of how much voltage is supplied, or what is the frequency of the voltage supplied to that circuitry. Or you can also observe what type of voltage, what is the waveform of the voltage signal. Through that, you can also identify whether the circuitry that you are going to check has harmonic effects. I have only mentioned few, but there are a lot more practices that you can get from an oscilloscope. So as I told you, this oscilloscope probe, you are going to connect this end to the channel. There are two channels, channel 1 and channel 2. I have plugged in an oscilloscope probe already to the channel 2. So I will show you how to plug the oscilloscope probe to channel 1. So you just have to simply insert the socket and turn it. Then it automatically locks, so you can't pull it back. So now if you see, in your oscilloscope probe, there are two settings mentioned as into 1 and into 100. The difference between this into 1 and into 100 is when you push this button into one section, which means your oscilloscope probe cap is connected with 100 mega ohm resistor. So when I connect this probe into some circuitry, it will protect the oscilloscope from getting any damage by high voltages. So 100 mega ohm is pretty much large resistance, so it will protect your oscilloscope from any high voltages without hurting your oscilloscope. Simply the probe will be burnt away. The use of into 10 setup is the signal that you are going to see from the screen will be 10 times smaller. That means from into 1, when you are in the into 1 mode, it is showing the original signal that comes from the circuit, the original voltage. But think an instant, your signal is giving out a voltage amplitude of 400 volts, and if you see this in the screen, it is unable for us to see. So we can try on putting onto the into the 10 mode and check whether we can see the signal properly. But you have to remember always that when you are taking the measurements, if you have put it into the 10 range, you have to multiply your measurement by 10. This affects only in the direction of y-axis, not on the x-axis. The time doesn't affect by this. Only the voltage is affected by this into the 10 scenario. So as per our requirement, we can change between two modes. But initially, we are recommended to test with into the one mode, because it has a protection which will protect your oscilloscope, and it is where you can see the original waveform, original signal that circuitry is supplied with the voltage. That's, I think, that those are the basic things that you need to know about this oscilloscope probe. Now I will go one by one about this oscilloscope, how to, before calibrating it, what are these knobs and switches that available on the oscilloscope. If we begin from here, there is a power switch on button. You can just switch it on, then this bulb is light up if it is properly switched on. When we switched on the oscilloscope, normally you are going to see this line. At the initial stage when you are power on, if you don't see this line, don't get worried. We can check what happened to it, whether there are few steps that you have to follow to recover this line. If even after following those steps, it is not showing the green line, then we have to decide there is some malfunctioning with the oscilloscope. So initially I have switched on the oscilloscope. There are three knobs that you have to work with adjusting this green line. First one is the intensity knob. From this, you can change the intensity of the signal, voltage signal. Currently, I have not supplied any voltage signals, but you can see what happens. It increases, we can increase or decrease the intensity. Then, so as per our eyesight, you can change the intensity and adjust it as you want. Then the focus button. Focus button is to adjust the focus of the signal. If there are any blurred situation, you can change your focus rotation and clear out your signal. Both these nodes can be used before you are connecting to a circuitry or after you are connecting to a circuitry if the signal is blurred or intensity is too high for you to observe. Then you can also again adjust using these two buttons, intensity and the focus. Then initially you can see this line is straight, but there are some times when we power it on, it has fluctuations due to the voltage supply this oscilloscope gets. So we cannot initially start with the fluctuating line. We have to have a straight line. So from this trigger section, the level holder knob, we can adjust this level button and make this to be a straight line. As I highlight again, you have to start with a straight green line. Otherwise, it will be difficult for us to calibrate. And if our calibration is wrong, then the whole readings we are going to do test with in future will be wrong. So you can make it back to a straight line again using this in trigger section level button. Then after that, you can see, now I am going to describe you how to calibrate the oscilloscope. When we are engaging with describing how to calibrate the oscilloscope, you can go through all the knobs and switches on this section. So I will start from there. So for calibrating the oscilloscope, you have to connect your oscilloscope probe, this hook part, into the calibration point. If you see, there is a calibration connecting point where I can hook this oscilloscope probe. Now you can see a change in the screen. It is showing up some kind of signal that is automatically generated by the oscilloscope for you to calibrate your oscilloscope. If you keenly see on the oscilloscope display, in here it mentioned as cal 2 volt peak to peak and 1 kilohertz. These are the values that we need to calibrate. In the y axis you have to have a signal which has an amplitude of 2 volt peak to peak, not peak 2 volt peak to peak. And in your time axis, it should be arranged in such a way that your voltage signal is having a 1 kilohertz frequency. So as you know, the basic equations, F equals 1 over T, if you know the frequency, you can calculate what is the time. So here it mentioned as 1 kilohertz. So if you do your math, you can get your time zone, T is equal to 1 millisecond. So what does it mean? You have to calibrate your voltage signal in such a way that one duty cycle should have an amplitude of 2 volt peak to peak, and it should have one duty cycle should end within a 1 millisecond time of period, which will make your signal a frequency with 1 kilohertz. So that is our purpose to do. Now, from the beginning of the video, I told you the y-axis represents voltage and the x-axis represents time. So now I have to adjust this y-axis and x-axis. First, I am going to adjust my y-axis, which is the voltage axis. For that, As per I told you, we have two channels. Now I am going to calibrate for channel 1. So from the beginning, I have to select my mode. In this oscilloscope, there are 4 modes. If you can see, mode 1 is channel 1, which means it will show the signal which is given to channel 1. If I move it to channel 2, it will show the signal connected to oscilloscope channel 2. Initially, it's not connected to anything, so it shows the basic straight green line. Then the third mode is dual. In the dual mode, at once it shows both the channels, channel 1 and channel 2, both the signals in channel 1 and channel 2. Then the fourth mode, which is add. In the add mode, it gives the addition of channel 1 and channel 2 signal. I suppose everybody is familiarized with signal additions. So that scenario is applied in mode add. So the addition of both the channels is given by the mode add. So as initially I am going to calibrate for channel 1, I am going to put my mode into channel 1. Then, now I only have to focus on the buttons on channel 1 section only. The same thing repeats for the channel 2 also. So I will describe these parts. So it is same repeated in here also. For channel 1, to adjust y-axis, remember now I am adjusting y-axis, which means the voltage. This part, the voltage division, volts per division, which means if you see on the screen, on the y-axis, you can see this whole plot is consisting of small squares. This one square is 1 by 1 centimeter. If you see the center line, you can see that this one small square is again divided into 5 parts, 5 smaller parts from both sides, X and Y, which means based on these parts, I can get my measurements. The smallest measurement, as per I told you, this is a 1 by 1 centimeter, the smallest measurement will be 0.2 centimeters. So when I convert this into volts or time, that depends on what this one square represents for. So now I will go back to volts per division. What meant by volts per division now? This means in y-axis, from one square, how many volts are represented? So if I put my volts per division into 0.5, it means on the y-axis, from the one square represent 0.5 volt. So addition of two squares on the y-axis means 1 volt. Likewise, you can calculate up to whatever you want. Right? So then, when you are calibrating, I hope you remember, you have to calibrate for 2 volt peak-to-peak signal. So, as per my requirement, I have to make a 2 volt peak-to-peak signal. So, I can decide what type of voltage division I need and then put it into that section. I am putting 1 volt per division. That means on the y-axis, 1 square represents, 1 full square represents 1 volt. Then, if you see, again there are 3 modes on the channel 1 selection. AC, ground and DC. What is meant by this AC, DC and ground? AC and DC and ground means, in the AC mode what happens is, your signal is showing on only the AC part of the voltage signal that is connected to your oscilloscope. It blocks off the DC part of the signal. If I put it into DC, then it shows both AC and DC. Both AC part and DC. So, you know, in a DC voltage value, there it should not supposed to have negative values. So, if you can see, when I put it into AC mode, the signal is on here. When I push back into DC mode, you can see the signal is uplift, which means DC doesn't have negative voltages. But remember, in AC mode, it only shows the AC part of the voltage signal. But in DC mode, it shows both AC and DC part of the voltage signal together. So what happens in ground mode? Ground mode, what happens is, oscilloscope cut off everything it is connected and ground the equipment. So it doesn't receive any signals, even it is generated from own oscilloscope. It's grounded. So this mode is initially we used to set up our origin position, from where we are going to measure the begin our measurement. So to set up that, I use these positioning buttons. From this position button, you can change your green line into up and down. You can set up it into anywhere that you are. So this will be your base. That means center of this will be your considered as your zero. Now I have set up my zero. Then for the calibration, I put it into AC mode. So now you can see, before adjusting my signal, this is moving very fast. But with this, I cannot do any calibrations. It is difficult for my eyes also. So using this trigger level holder, you can freeze your signal. You can stop it. With smooth precisions, you can stop your signal like this. And then move on to adjusting your signal, where we want to adjust up my voltage signal amplitude into 2 volt peak to peak, to use this calibrator button. What happens with this calibrate knob, which is in the inside the voltage division knob, embedded with the voltage division knob, you can, if you see, when I lock this calibrator, you can, I hope that you can hear this clicking sound. When I lock this, no matter what in which division we are, if there is no malfunction in the oscilloscope, it should calibrate your voltage signal amplitude exactly onto 2 volt peak to peak. So remember, this part is the calibrator of voltage amplitude. Once we lock this knob, we are not removing this calibrator, we are not changing the position of the calibrator throughout the practical. So if we change it, it will change our initial calibration. So the whole readings we are going to get it will be wrong. So remember, we are, after locking this part, we are not changing it. If again, another important fact is, when we lock it in any voltage division, it should adjust, calibrate your voltage signal's amplitude into 2 volt peak to peak. So if you look at on the screen, I have put it into 1 volts per division, which means 1 square represents 1 volt. So if you see peak to peak voltage, you can see I begin from the center, there is plus 1 for the positive side, plus 1 for the negative side. So peak-to-peak voltage becomes 2 volt. Now think of a scenario if the voltage divisions I set up for 0.5 volt. So now you have to do your calculations. So which means whole signal should be within 4 squares. So now as I told you, when we lock this button, it automatically sets your calibration to volt 2 volt peak to peak, no matter in which voltage division. So we will check whether it is true or not. Now I am putting back into 0.5 volts per division. Now you can see the whole signal peak to peak contains within 4 squares. If you multiply 0.5 by 4, which gives 2, which means 2 volt peak to peak. Now we have adjusted your y-axis, the voltage axis, for the calibration part. Then now we will move on to horizontal adjustments, which is the x-axis or the time axis, where you have to adjust your time of the signal to be 1 millisecond to make your voltage signal into a 1 kilohertz frequency. For that, it is mentioned horizontal, where you can do the adjustment on horizontal axis. You have several knobs. Now I am going to do the adjustments on my horizontal axis. Again, there is a time division knob. On the x-axis side, from this time division, what is meant? As same as in the voltage division, in time division, from the value it is on, which means 1 square is now 1 millisecond. 1 millisecond. That means I initially told you this is the 0th point. 0. So value on here will be 1 millisecond. Here 2 millisecond. Here 3 milliseconds. Likewise. So I have put it into 1 millisecond. Which means now I am going to calibrate my signal also for 1 millisecond. That means your signal, the whole 1 duty cycle should be within 1 millisecond time. That means your whole signal should be containing within 1 square, 1 duty cycle. At current moment, it is not happening like that. To change your pulse width, you use this swap var button. This is the calibrator for time axis. Likewise, in the y-axis, this was the calibrator. For time axis, this is the calibrator. Now, I am changing this knob to adjust my pulse width to make it a 1 kilohertz voltage signal. Now I had adjusted it to be likewise. So remember, after adjusting it, you are not supposed to change this knob. Again, I am highlighting that you are not supposed to change this knob from the positioning button. Now you can see your one whole duty cycle is fit within one square, which means it is within 1 millisecond. If you convert it, so the frequency will be 1 kilohertz. After doing that, you are not supposed to change this button at all during your practical, which will change your calibration on the x-axis. So now you are perfectly okay with calibrating your oscilloscope. So I hope those things are the basic things that you need to know about how to calibrate a oscilloscope. Thank you for watching this video. Have a nice day.